Close that outer eye. Keep your head to the sky. Close the outer eye. Keep your head to the sky, from which cometh our help. We turn toward the mountain. We look towards the mountain from which cometh our help, the hills, which means higher consciousness. We look to higher consciousness because we can't solve the problem at the level of the problem. We can't solve the problem at the valley consciousness. We got to go to the mountaintop and look over and see the promised land of our own being. So we turn within in this moment. It is my privilege and honor to speak the word for each and every one of us. I say it frequently and I mean it, that it is an honor, and I get to do this. This is what I get to do. This is a part of my dharma. It's not all of it, but it's a part of my dharma to get to do this. I get to pray for all of these individuals tuning in to Agape right now. I get to stand on the precipice of the knowledge of this moment and feel the deep sense of gratitude and thanksgiving and dynamic appreciation for life itself. And to feel so richly endowed with the presence and the flow of life moving through me right now, that I get to recognize that God is everywhere. I get to recognize that the presence is never an absence. Everywhere, 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 teeming with itself. And to feel my oneness with it. Come on with me. Come on upstairs, as Dr. Homer Johnson used to say. Come on upstairs with me. Come on upstairs. I know. No. Don't look over the balcony. I know there's some issues there. There's some problems there. Don't look over the balcony right now. Just come on upstairs. And begin to revel in the awareness that the presence is everywhere. Oneness with God. It is here at this higher dimension. The word that is spoken is the solar logos of the presence. It's the word of God. I speak it for each and every one of us that we may be free today. Free to be healthy. Every organ, action, function of the body, temple is made every whit whole. Give yourself permission to have a new thought around your body temple. Give yourself permission to be whole right now. Don't ask how, just tune into the what. What is the what? Wholeness. Ah, right now. Wellness, right now. Well-being, right now. Vitality, right now. Vigor, right now. I speak the word that wholeness cascades as harmonizing prosperity out of nothing. Real wealth. Vitality, wisdom, transforming knowledge, creative intelligence, creativity itself, inspiration. Oh my God, my God, my God, all of this looms large in our awareness. I want you to feel this. And I want you to come with me into the land of intentionality now. Let's have an intention together. Thousands of people tuning in now and later. Let us now have an intentionality that humanity itself, immune system becomes so strong that we become immune to COVID-19 and other diseases that may arise from time to time. It's an intention. We're establishing an intention right now. Individually and collectively, our immune system is becoming strong. We're one with each other. We're one with God. So if anyone has an insight around this, it affects the whole group. When anyone breaks free from time, breaks free from fear, breaks free from the misguided education around this, it lifts everyone. Let's have an intention now to be free, that deaths cease around this disease, and that those that leave the body temple, it's their time. It's an intention. Nothing happens without intention. Let's not live by default in statistics. Let's live by design in real life. That's an intention right now. That humanity, immune system. Let's embrace the planet now and have an intention that the deforestation that's happening around greed, tearing down forest for the feeding of cattle, polluting the environment, taking up land that can be used for the lungs of the world, and feeding all of that cattle food that can be fed to people that need food. Let's see the end of that kind of unconsciousness by individuals that are living in an old paradigm. Let's see our rainforest thriving. Let's have an intention, a group intention, to see our rainforest thriving. Let's have a group intention to see our rivers clean, our oceans clean, our lakes clean, our soil replenished. It's so difficult now for people to get food that has the full vitamin content that it used to have because the soil itself has been degraded over time by misuse and unconsciousness. Let's have an intention now to heal the planet. Let's bless those that are working in these particular areas of activism. Climate change individuals, those that are working, Alana, those that are working with our rainforest, individual that we helped start with the initial funding for her to plant trees. She's planted thousands of trees now in the rainforest, and we're about to support her again. Not her, we're supporting us. Rivers, lakes. Oh, let's see an end to the desert, the food deserts in certain communities where there's nowhere for no farmers markets, no fresh produce. They have to go outside the community to get it, or they have to subsist on fast foods and liquor stores. Come on. That's not the kind of world we want to live in. Let's establish an intention right now. That doesn't mean you have to go do it if that's not your particular point of activism, but you can see it, and it'll help those that are working at becoming the tip of the spear of that particular kind of activism. Let's support them right now. See it. See it. See it. See it. See it. And feel it. I want you to feel it.